are just to release.
Watching over us last night and allowing us another opportunity to wake up and to walk in your wisdom, to walk in your glory, and to be obedient to you. Thank you for this opportunity. Lord, I ask that you walk with us today. Be with us. Love us. And help us to know that all that is going on, all that is going on at this very moment, at this very time, there is a purpose, there is a plan, and only you know. God, I want to say a prayer for our churches.
Yes.
God, please, Lord, allow us to get an understanding that there is a need for our people to be truly taught your word, putting all the stuff, tradition, the mess aside, and start really learning about you and your will and your desire for our lives, Lord. Help us to be more humble and more kind to people, God, to be more welcoming to people so they have a desire to come to the church. Help us to be able to reach out to the community, God, and to be all that you would have us be. Help us to be that example. That when people see us, they see our smile, that they have a desire to want to know what it is that is about us, that we have, that they would desire to have that same thing, Lord. Help us to just be an example, Lord. I just want to be an example. Help us to have more compassion, God, for your people. Help us to want to help more, God. Lord, I just want to pray that the church be a more true example of who you really are, God. Not about fashion and not about this and that. We're just ordinary people wanting to serve God and help his people. Help us to become that example more and more. I pray for the pastors, Lord. I pray for all the pastors, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
In the name of Jesus, I pray.
Remind the people to be subject to rulers and authorities, to be obedient, to be ready to do whatever is good, to slander no one, to be peaceable and considerate, and always to be gentle toward everyone. At one time, we too were foolish, disobedient, deceived, and enslaved by all kinds of passions and pleasures. We lived in malice and envy, being hated and hating one another. But when the kindness and love of God our Savior appeared, He saved us, not because of righteous things we had done, but because of His mercy. He saved us through the washing of rebirth and renewal by the Holy Spirit, whom He poured out on us generously through Jesus Christ our Savior, so that, having been justified by His grace, we might become heirs, having the hope of eternal life. This is a trustworthy saying. And I want you to stress these things so that those who have trusted in God may be careful to devote themselves to doing what is good. These things are excellent and profitable for everyone. But avoid foolish controversies and genealogies and arguments and quarrels about the law, because these are unprofitable and useless. Warn divisive people once, and then warn them a second time. After that, have nothing to do with them. You may be sure that such people are warped and sinful. They are self-condemned. As soon as I send Artemis or Tychicus to you, do your best to come to me at Nicopolis, because I have decided to winter there. Do everything you can to help Zenas the lawyer and Apollos on their way, and see that they have everything they need. Our people must learn to devote themselves to doing what is good in order to provide for urgent needs and not live unproductive lives. Everyone with me sends you greetings. Greet those who love us in the faith. Grace be with you all.
The end of the book of Titus.
He He's calling you higher. There is more than I require of thee. He said, don't be afraid of men and their faces. Don't be afraid, don't be afraid, don't be afraid. He said, I'm calling you out of your dry places. I'm calling you out of your dry places. Say it. Come on up a little higher. Come on up a little higher. Come on up a little higher. 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 I'm calling you. I predestined you before the world began to do my will. To do my will.
What we said was that there are seven tests to determine whether or not God is or has spoken. There are how many tests? Seven tests. These seven tests will give you an indication whether or not God is or has spoken. Now, the key to the test is that it doesn't, what you want to do is you want to make sure that if you have an impression from God, an idea from God, something you believe God wants you to do, if someone has said something to you or prophesied over your life or whatever it is that's happened, any which way you feel that God has spoken to you, you want to submit each and every one of, you want to submit all of those to these seven tests. It doesn't, it's probably not from God if it only meets one of the tests. It's probably not from God if it meets five of the tests. It's probably, the likeliness that it is from God is that it will pass all seven tests. Test number four is this consistent with how God shaped me? Listen, does this thing agree with how God has shaped me? And shape, we talk about this in class 301. Shape, S stands for your spiritual gifts. How has God gifted you? H stands for your heart. What are your passions? And all of us have different ones. And one of the problems in the church is that we get down on other people because they don't have the same passions we have. Like, stop it. Abilities. What are my natural abilities? What are just some things I was born with that I can do? Everybody doesn't have the same. Some people are, listen, singing is not a spiritual gift because it is not necessarily acquired after you are saved. But singing is a natural ability, meaning you are born with vocal cords. I wasn't born with them. So if anybody ever says, Pastor, we want you to lead this song. It doesn't mean I can't lead it. It just means God didn't tell me to do so. Are y'all with me? Because it's not how I'm shaped. All right? P stands for personality. What's my personality? Right? Am I an over the topper? Am I a sanguine kind of person? I'm a low talker. Am I just loud and boisterous? Right? Who am I? What is my personality? Right? And then what are my experiences? Because the steps of a good man are ordered by the Lord. So God has allowed certain experiences in your life that he has not allowed in other people's lives. Why? Probably because he has a particular thing he wants to do with you, through you, in those experiences or through those experiences. So number two, watch this. Shape reveals function. Shape reveals function. Let me give you an example. When I walk up here and I see this, I assume I'm supposed to sit in it. Now, when I see this, this don't make me want to sit down. It's not shaped for sitting down. It wasn't created to be sat on. Are y'all with me? So form follows function. Function follows form. What something is determines its use. How God has shaped you determines what he wants you to do. So when people go to telling you that you're going to be this particular thing and they see this all in you and that's not how you're shaped, you know for sure God hasn't told them to tell you. Romans 12, just as each of us has one body with many members, and these members do not have the same function, so in Christ, we who are many form one body, and each member belongs to all the others. Underline that one part. Each member belongs to all the others. We have different gifts according to the grace given us. If a man's gift is prophesying, let him use it in proportion to his faith. A. I am shaped by God for other people. Woo, let that make sense. He says, we are members of a body and we belong to all the others. Meaning this, God doesn't have to give me all of the gifts inside of me. Why? Because he put gifts inside of you to share with me. And my gifts he put in me to share with you. So when I come to church and I'm a part of a church and all I do is sit on the pew and don't get active or involved or do anything, I'm cheating the other parts of the body from the gifts that God has put in me. I need for you to unlearn. You cannot be whatever you want to be if you set your mind to it. That's a lie from the pit. No, ma'am, no, sir. That's a lie we tell our kids. You can be whatever you want to be if you put your mind to it. No, they cannot. You cannot. You can be everything God shaped you to be, but not everything you want to be. I'm telling you right now, I can't be Luther Vandross. No matter how much I want it, no matter how much I... See, some of us like to sing. Some of us love singing, but some of us can sing. That's why they need to have CPS at American Idol. Because some of them folks come up there and them... parents be running them little babies up there, can't hold a note in a bucket. And talking about how good they baby sang, they baby get up there sound like a frog with a hiccup. Listen, CPS need to show up because you have not loved that kid. You've neglected your duty as a parent.